And the situation in the Middle East has become a talking point for the Prime Minister as he kicks off his visit to Southeast Asia. Today he sat down with his counterpart in Singapore in the first of three stops for Christopher Luxon as he looks to increase economic and security ties across the region. Senior political reporter Benedict Collins has more.
Singapore rolling out the red carpet for Christopher Luxon for the Prime Minister's first major foray into Asia.
We used to be able to see the harbour from here.
On this trip, trade and regional security are front of mind.
We're a country of 5 million people. There's a world out there of 195 other countries and 8 billion people. It's very important for us that we do business with as many people as we possibly can.
We think that there's scope for us to do even more, and therefore we've decided that next year we're going to substantially elevate the enhanced partnership.
But the flare-up in the Middle East is also commanding attention. The Prime Minister condemning Iran, not so much Israel.
It's what we've seen as an Iranian strike, which is unprecedented from Iranian soil onto Israeli soil, and that is something that we just don't want to see an escalation in the region.
Do you feel like Israel provoked Iran?
Again, I'm not getting into that.
Singapore Airlines today announcing it will be avoiding flying over Iranian airspace.
I think it's a very troubled world. Nothing is going to solve the problems in the Middle East within the foreseeable future. They can be managed.
Aside from security, the Prime Minister's hoping to turbocharge trade in the region. And get the message across, we're open for business.
It's a market that is a gateway market to Southeast Asia and Asia and about 650 million consumers.
And there's a fair bit riding on this trip for Christopher Luxon.
Look, I think for Christopher Luxon, it's about getting runs on the board. This is his first major international trip. I think he'll be happy to get this trip done without making any major gaffes or major mistakes.
The only mistake so far coming from the Singaporean Prime Minister.
Australia is not in. I keep on saying the wrong country.
And our Prime Minister's tour of Southeast Asia begins.
Talk of extending our partnership with Singapore, Benedict. What areas are we talking about?
Yeah, well, 5 years ago, New Zealand and Singapore, we signed a deal agreeing to work more closely together on a range of issues. Now, today, Prime Ministers Luxon and Prime Minister Lee, that they said they want to take this deal to the next level. And they're particularly interested in trying to iron out kinks in the supply chain. They were saying that during the pandemic, Singapore sent much-needed medical supplies to New Zealand, and in turn, New Zealand sent much-needed food to Singapore. They want to make sure that during an emergency, these supply chains are working as efficiently as possible. Also, as part of that, we're expecting a Singaporean delegation focused on food security to come down to New Zealand, I think, later this year. And there's also talk about closer defence ties as well with Singapore. We're expecting the Singaporean Defence Force to come down to New Zealand next year and restart doing live fire exercises. And there's also talk about the Singaporean military perhaps being interested in using New Zealand airspace to fly military drones.
All right, first off, Singapore. What's next on the Prime Minister's itinerary?
Well, we've got another day in Singapore yet. Tonight, the Prime Minister's got a big gala dinner with the trade delegation that's accompanying us on this trip. He's hoping to open a few doors for New Zealand businesses over here. From there, we'll head to Thailand, and then we'll round out the week heading over to the Philippines. And it's been a long time since the New Zealand Prime Minister visited there on an official trip.
Kia ora, Benedict. Thank you very much for that.